Okay, I'm in the middle of doing some grouting here. I've already done a shower. I'm about to do the floor. And I'll just give you some techniques and tips to use when you're doing grouting. First thing is the tools. You want to use a rubber float. This is a hard rubber float. They make some soft, spongy ones. I don't really like those, and I don't think anybody does anymore. That's kind of old school. These hard rubber ones are great, and especially when you're using sanded grout, it's important to have that harder edge to it. Sanded grout, of course, is used when you have a larger grout line. The other big tool is a sponge, and it may seem silly, but it's important to get the right sponge. Sponges designed for grouting release water very good and also absorb it very good, but it does both very quickly. The last thing you want to do is introduce too much water to this process. Then you'll get discoloration in the grout, and the strength of the grout won't be as great. So, and of course the other issue is the grout itself. That's the sanded grout. You want a fairly stiff mix. I mean, this is, you can actually see the sand in it, and you know it'll hold its own there. It won't fall off. So you want, if anything, err on the side of being a little bit dry. Now, when you're wiping with the sponge, that's really the key to this whole process. And what you want to do is, as you're wiping, you're also turning the sponge like that, right? And you're going to get one swipe, and you turn the sponge over, get another swipe, and that's it. And if you follow that advice, definitely the key to the whole thing. When you rinse out your sponge, you're going to rinse it out as best you can. Get that whole thing in your hand and squeeze all the water out. There shouldn't be any water left. I even do this just to make sure there's nothing left. So when I bring it open, there's no water left. It's just damp. And that's it. Again, if you introduce too much water when you're wiping, then the grout is going to discolor and you'll get a weaker bond. All right? So let me do some actual grouting here and show you how this works. Working in aggressively, and then we do a little bit at a time. The important thing is just to get the whole grout line filled. And you don't have to be too careful about it right now. But I'm really pressing hard here. I mean, I'm giving it a good workout. And when you knock off the excess, you can do that at a slight angle. That usually helps. All right, that's about as big a section as I would do at one time. And next I'll do the wiping. Again, I'm squeezing all the water out, making sure there's nothing there. And I'm turning as I wipe, all right? I'll get one more swipe out of that. And that's it. Rinse it out. No water. One swipe. And one more on this side. And I'll just keep going. So I only do a few feet at a time. And there's no going back. I mean, once you've done this, you're done. There may be a slight haze after it totally dries, but that'll wipe out with a paper towel. So that's really it. There's no secret other than not to use too much water, make sure your grout mix is not too wet, and just turn as you're wiping the sponge, and you're done. I wipe on a slight diagonal angle. And that's it. Easy as pie.